Hi, I'm Ram Gopal from presentationprocess.com. In this video, you will learn how to create PowerPoint Zoom animation. The awesome Zoom animation effect you will learn to create today looks like this. As you can see here, we have a beautiful picture of a world map. In this map, I want to focus only on South America. The way I do this is, on a click, I have South America highlighted, and then I zoom in on South America. Isn't this beautiful? It's such a useful technique that you can use this to zoom in on a specific step in a large multi-stage process, or you can use this to zoom in on a specific individual in a group photo, or you can use this effect to zoom in on a specific country in a world map like the way that we are doing now. Are you interested to learn how to create this awesome effect from scratch? Wonderful, let's jump right in. I'm going to start with this large picture, which covers the entire slide end to end. The first step in creating PowerPoint Zoom animation is to duplicate the slide. So I'm going to select the slide, right click and go to Duplicate Slide option. Now as you can see, we have two copies of the same slide. The next step is to decide on the area we want to focus on. In this case, we want to focus only on South America. So let me go to Auto Shapes menu. Under Basic Shapes, let us pick up this tool called as Oval tool. I'm going to hold the Shift button down as I draw a circle which covers the area I want to focus on. The next step is to select the circle, go to Shape Fill and choose No Fill. Then I'm going to choose a different color for the outline so the outline very clearly stands out from the rest of the photo. In this case, I want to choose black color for my outline. Then let me go to the same shape outline option, and this time I want to increase the weight from the default 1 point to 6 points. As you can see here, the area we want to focus on is very clearly demarcated. The next step is to crop this picture in such a way that we only retain this area and remove the rest. It's very simple to do. The way to do this is first select the picture, go to the Format tab in PowerPoint ribbon, and choose the Crop tool. I'm not going to click on the Crop icon here. I'm going to open up a small drop-down menu which comes when I click on the small arrow under the Crop icon. And here you can see the drop-down menu. I'm going to choose Crop to Shape option here. The option I'm going to choose is under Basic Shapes, and it is the same option that I've used to create the circular highlight. So let me go to the Oval tool. And as you can see here, as soon as I clicked on the Oval tool, the picture is now cropped in the oval form. Now, as you can see, we want this shape to be in a perfect circle rather than in this elliptical shape. So let me go to the Crop tool option once again. And this time I'm going to choose the aspect ratio of 1:1. Now that gives me a perfectly circular cropping area. Now, all I need to do is to adjust the circular cropping area so it focuses only on the area I want to focus on. So let me go to this handle here, which I see in the corner, and I'm going to hold the Shift button down as I drag this handle so it focuses on the area that I have chosen earlier. As you can see here, I have got the outline of the earlier circle shown, and that is where I stop. Then I'm going to work on this corner. I'm going to hold the Shift button down, and I'm going to work my way so I'm able to crop this pretty much inside the circle that I had drawn earlier. I'm going to work from this corner, and I'm going to do the same, and I'm going to work from the other corner as well. Now, one last adjustment from this side. Now I have a perfectly cropped circular area in this large picture. Now when I click outside, you can see that only the area that I want to focus on remains and the rest is removed. Beautiful. Now the next step is to select both these shapes, press Ctrl X, which is the shortcut for cut, go back to the earlier picture and press Ctrl V. So both the objects are pasted exactly in the same spot that we worked on in the earlier duplicate slide. Now we don't want this duplicate slide, so I'm going to delete it. Now we are going to work only with this slide. Here we have two objects. First is the circle. Second is the circular cropped area. The way we are going to achieve PowerPoint Zoom animation is by selecting both these objects. The way we do this is by clicking and dragging the cursor across these two objects so we can select both the objects together. Then let us go to the Animations tab in PowerPoint Ribbon, and let me keep the animation pane open by clicking on this so you can clearly follow what I'm going to do. The next step is to choose a specific animation to emphasize these two objects. So let me go to the options here, and the animation option I am going to choose is under emphasis, and it is called as grow shrink animation. As soon as I did that, you can see that both the objects are animating simultaneously, and it's beautiful. While this effect is beautiful, I want to do one more thing. First, I want the circle to appear with wheel animation, and then I want the zoom animation to happen. For that, all I need to do is to select the circle here, then go to add animation. This is very important. I don't want you to choose the options here because that will replace whatever that we have done earlier. So I want to add animation, and the entrance animation that I'm going to choose in this case is wheel animation. As you can see here, the wheel animation brings in the circle in a beautiful way. Now, if you see in the animation pane, you can see three animation events. On the first click, you can see that both this picture and the circle are getting zoomed in. And on the next click, we have the circle appearing with wheel animation. So we want to do a bit of readjustment in terms of the order of animation. First, we want the wheel animation to appear. So I'm going to click on this and move this up. So that is the first event that happens. After that event, we want the zoom animation to happen. So I'm going to click on this one and say, instead of start on click, we want to say start after previous. To translate these three animation events in plain English, on a click, we have the circle appear with wheel animation. And after that event, we have a zoom in animation of both this picture and the circle happening simultaneously. Now let us go to the slideshow mode and see the animation in action. On the first click, I have the oval appear with a wheel animation, and then the zoom in animation happens. Hope you really enjoyed this beautiful animation trick. If you did, I have a wonderful treat for you. I've put together a useful mini training called Learn 5 Simple Animation Tricks Under 5 Minutes to Make Your Slides Clear and Memorable. If you're a business presenter, like say you're a business owner, a business executive, a trainer, or a consultant, you will find this mini training absolutely useful. You can sign up for the mini training by clicking on the button here. You can also sign up for this mini training by clicking on the link I have provided in the description area right below this video. So go ahead, sign up for the mini training and take your business presentations to a whole new level. I'll see you inside the mini training.